Hey, what's up, guys? It's Pixelated Apollo. Thanks for stopping by, and today we are looking at this new mod called Ancient Empires for Total War Attila. And joining me in today's commentary, we have Indy Pride from Milk and Cookies.
Hey, what's going on, everybody?
Hello. How you doing, man?
I'm doing very well. How are you, my friend?
I am doing well. You ready for a nice ancient battle?
Yep, this is going to be Carthage versus two Roman Republic armies. I'll go over my army setup first, then we can go over Jackie Fish's and Pixelated Apollo's. So for my front line, a bunch of Libyan hoplites. Those will be kind of meat shields. Some African veterans, giving them that morale bonus to keep them in the fight for a longer period of time. As my core, three Sacred Band. You guys know them
very, awesome.
Very well. Extremely cool-looking units, and they are very tanky and survivable in melee. Also have some mercenary Celtic warband as my sword infantry. In the back, some Sardinian archers and some mercenary Celtic horse. And also have the one, the only Hannibal Barca as my general. I need to find him. Where is
he? Oh, there he is. Look at it. He's got his eye patch.
Yeah, he's right here. He's in the purple. Got his eye patch. And he is going to be leading this army against the Roman Republic.
The great Romans.
Right now.
Well, real quick, I just wanted to show, this is a very traditional Roman strategy here, where you you charge in the plebs first. It is more of a traditional thing. Don't worry, I did read this somewhere, so this is probably 100% correct. So right now I'm charging in the plebs, and they're gonna go ahead and take on the elephants here. I guess we'll go ahead and watch this charge before we look over the Roman army comps.
The Romans love sacrificing their citizens every day. It's really one of their biggest battle tactics.
Yes, they do.
Elephants are going to slam into them. And yeah, elephants are a little bit underwhelming in Attila. I talked about it before. They are not the Rome 2 powerhouses they were in previous games. But plebs are going to overlap. Elephants are going to try their best to run through. And it is interesting. If you try to pull through in any Attila mod or gameplay with elephants, you will lose them. So even though plebs are absolute trash, as you could imagine, I've already lost a couple of elephants, but they did cause some routing on the pleb line.
I swear I saw like one pleb take on an entire elephant. It's like, man, he's got fist of steel. Like, what is it?
Those big daggers, man. That's totally enough to bring down a full-grown African elephant. You know?
Yeah, for sure. But we're not missing much. Just my plebs charging in, you know, for the glory of Rome. But Jackie Fish and I, we pretty much have the same army comps. So we can pretty much just go over one. We're basically bringing Equites for Cav. So I think we have like four total as an army. And then we're bringing the Hastati in the front line. So we're bringing about four units of them, or actually eight total, maybe. I'm not sure. And then behind them, we have the Principes. So there we go. Secondary line. And then in the third line, we have the Triarii. So traditional Roman army comp here. Pretty excited to see them in action. For the general, though, I am bringing a special general. It is Scipio. How do you pronounce it?
Also known as Publius Cornholius Scipio Africanus.
Scipio.
So he's going to be going up against Hannibal Barca. And I don't know where he is, actually.
He's behind my lines. Oh, in the unit?
Yeah, I think I might be looking at him, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, I named him Scipio. I see him. I think he's got a red cape. Yeah, that's him. That's him. I know what he looks like. I've seen him before. Alright, so, yeah cool, we...
Sick, bro. You were alive 2,500 years ago. Easy.
I am a time traveler. So, we are moving up forward. So, we're going to slowly approach your forces. We do heavily outnumber you, so you're going to try to use this hill against us and hopefully hold all the flanks. This mod's really cool. I guess since we have some time to talk about the mod before the armies engage here. The mod seems really solid. Lots of like huge unit scaling, which is really awesome. And the fighting goes on forever, which, you know, some people like, some people dislike. Here's a cav charge.
Oh, that was just right there.
Oh,
that
is God.
That was more along the lines of traditional Attila cav charges, where the impact damage just sends stuff flying. Unfortunately, a lot of the plebs are going to survive. They still have 90 men left in the unit. And after the charge bonus wears off, that's where melee fights do get a little bit grindy. So you'll see these plebs are stuck in combat with pretty high tier mercenary Celtic cavalry, actually. And they're going to drop models very, very slowly. But that is what this mod is going for, is that it's going for more morale shocks are what cause units to rout, not so much the actual killing power of units. So you'll see a lot of infantry units engage each other and fight for a very long time, but it's the flanking charges and those flanking bonuses, the morale penalties, that will get the battles going quicker in your favor. So if you want to do well in this mod, the best way to do it is tie down enemy infantry. Even if you have crap tier infantry, they'll hold the line for a decent amount of time, and that will allow your cavalry and elephants and whatever shock troops you have to get into a flanking position and end them rightly with a back charge. So that's what he's going to be, what we're going to be going for in this battle. I am massively outnumbered. We did do a 1v2. Yeah. They left some funds on the table, but I'm still pretty heavily outnumbered here with my Carthaginian
troops. I think what we should have done was just do large armies, but we each bring 20 and you bring 40 units.
Because
we still have the advantage in like micro, but you would have, you know, an equal amount of troops. There's some major changes compared to like normal Attila in this mod, where fatigue is a very important factor. That is why we're slowly marching up our army, because your troops can get tired really quickly and it really affects their performance in battle. So you gotta watch out for that in this mod. And I think I really enjoy that. I think it makes it a little bit more strategic, and you gotta make sure you have your troops in the right position. Because if you're out of position and you have to run them over, it's going to be pretty bad. But here comes the first charge of Hastati.
Hastati going in right now, throwing some of their Pila to get into the front of my Libyan hoplites. And we're going to hold the line here. Actually, did not go into shield wall. I do not know the effect shield wall has. The guys are so tanky in this anyway, it doesn't really matter. But over on my right flank, Hannibal Bark are going to charge directly into the Ecrates, and also my elephants can back me up over on this side. So I'm going to try to flank them around and get a rear charge off. And I must say that I haven't really seen too many mods that rival this one in terms of sheer scope. The big unit size and just playing on 40 unit cap really makes you feel like you're in an ancient battle, which is obviously why a lot of us play Total War. It really does give you that epic sense of scale that I think a lot of, if you play like on 20 unit cap and kind of make it less epic, but with this, with the bigger unit sizes, it's really cool looking, I think.
Yeah, it's amazing. I mean, just seeing the Roman legions, and it's pretty awesome.
And I love when they march too. Like when you actually march your units instead of just sprint them across the open battlefield, there's something way more like epic and tense about seeing that massive army just marching in formation instead of like sprinting across the battlefield.
It feels more authentic. I don't know. And also when they go into Testudo, it's a really cool sound effect that they added to the mod. So, we got a really intense battle line over here. Looks like the fight for the flank is somewhat going in your favor. I think you're throwing in some Sacred Band, maybe?
I actually got a back charge with the elephants into the cavalry over on my right flank against Shacky Fish. And now I'm basically going to throw like a holding force at you, because I know I can't actually beat you. But I am going to throw a Sacred Band and a couple of Mercenary Scutari to just hold the line over on this side while I focus on beating Jackie Fish's army. So I'm going to focus on that real quick. I've actually broken one of his cavalry units. You can see the equipes are breaking with 108 men. That was because of the back charge from the elephants. And look, actually a lot of wavering over here. Triarii with only 4 casualties.
Wow.
Wrapping. That's with the morale kicking in. It's that if you get that rear charge with an elephant unit, you're going to be able to cause those fear penalties.
They're
because probably, obviously, in real life, you don't like getting charged in the back by elephants.
Yeah, I don't blame them. But they should return, right? I mean, unless you keep, picking at them, but
I'm going to keep on their ass and make sure they don't come back, because that is
smart.
A full unit of Triarii. It's really important to make sure that they don't come back. And if I'm going to win this battle, it's really the only way I can, is with those hammer and anvils and making sure that units that rout actually completely shatter.
Oh, man. Yeah, so I was getting kind of worried about that flank. I was like, oh my god, he's really pushing through. So eventually I do push over some infantry and some of my, I send over my general to kind of help Jackie Fish, because we can't lose that flank or we're for sure going to lose. Also, we had a cav engagement also on the other side, and it's pretty even. It looks like you defeated one of my cav units, but the other cav units are still fighting over here. And I'm throwing in some Hastati to join the fight.
Yeah, and I now have a free mercenary Celtic cavalry. We'll see what I choose to do with that. I wanted to make sure they were kind of unengaged at the moment, just make sure that nothing got into my archers at the moment. But I did get Hannibal Barca into the back of the Hastati over on Jackie Fish's left flank. That is going to hurt him tremendously. gonna pull out and cycle charge again. And he actually did something that was very smart. He pulled one of his Principe units into a square formation, which really helps them against cavalry charges, even though I'm not sure how historically accurate that would be, considering that the square itself is only like 2 or 3 ranks deep. Cavalry would be able to penetrate that box.
Yeah. But it's
pretty
cool.
But it works really well in this mod. Yeah, and it allows the shields to face outside and prevent those cavalry charges.
Go ahead.
I just have a lot of free cav here, and I can now start going for those back charges into the main line, which can maybe turn things in my favor.
I was just going to say, it kind of makes cav less important a little bit, you know, where if you don't have the best cav in the world, it's not the end of the world where you can just form square and kind of deal with the cav. But I still think cav is pretty vital in this mod.
The killing power isn't as much as it is in Attila, just because the impact damage and stuff has been toned down. But they still cause morale penalties better than any other unit, because you have the mobility to get a rear charge off and make sure those units don't come back, which is where they rack up all these kills. Because like killing the unit outright is really hard, but when they're running, it becomes a lot easier.
Yeah, and you're doing a great job over here. I was actually trying to outflank you with some Hastati, and you got a really good cav charge, and they're breaking right now, so that's very good map awareness there. But I am setting in more troops to continue to flank around and just keep pushing. Yeah, it's just the Roman way, you know? Just keep sending in troops, and hopefully you'll win the war.
Send them into the meat grinder. Yes, the Principes are now getting into a pretty threatening position. They could now have an opportunity to back charge this entire blob. I'm gonna focus fire on the Principes. Their shields are facing me. Not an ideal target, but do want to do as much damage as possible. Good thing is I still have this mercenary Celtic cavalry free and ready to charge into stuff. So if you do go for that hammer and anvil on the infantry line, I can then hammer and anvil you, and it kind of snowballs from there. But I have broken a lot of Jack the Fish's left flank. Elephants up to 446 kills, even though a lot of them were on plebs. I did manage to grab those Triarii and those Sestati. And now Hannibal Barca is in an engagement, but he really doesn't want to be in against two Equite units and Scipio. That's probably not the best engagement for him.
Yeah, no, your general is he's in trouble, especially with some extra Principes coming over this way to support the cab. Or actually, you know what? These guys are just flanking around. Never mind. They're going to help Jackie Fish. So yeah, I am sending over infantry now to help Jackie Fish. Here are the Triarii who are now joining this cab engagement, which is pretty cool. I mean, everywhere you look, there's some just massive amount of troops fighting, which is always very fun to watch.
Yeah, we started this battle, I had 3,600 men, they had 8,500, so tons of units on the field. Really big battle. Oakley and me played for the first time, it was like 6,000 versus 8,000 troops, which is pretty insane. But I just got another rear charge off on those Principes that you did manage to flank around, which is very dangerous to my infantry, but hopefully they'll hold and I'll be able to rout those Principes. And this cabin has caused a lot of damage so far. They're up to 236 kills already.
Yeah, I mean, just look at this fight over here on that flank. This is insane. Tons and tons of troops in one area. Your Sacred Band, they're holding like a bunch of bosses, man. They're so good. And the frame rate is just...
That optimization. Attila optimization. So good. So good.
It's
beautiful.
Perfecto. It's wonderful.
Oh, muy bueno. Okay, so over there... I've been doing okay. I'm just trying to hold the line, but again, on Jackie Fish's left flank is really what happened.
You got a cab charge coming in.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna try to turn around, try to stop it. I do slow it down a little bit, but you're gonna continue to push and do a lot of damage to the backs of Jackie Fish's army.
Yeah, that was about as perfect as a hammer and anvil as you could possibly get. And that is going to cause some wavering. Look at that.
Wow.
Two units, almost full units of Astati routing. Yeah. And I'm going to get another rear charge off into these other Principes that are engaging against my Sacred Band in a second as soon as I pull them out. I have noticed the cavalry is a lot stickier in this mod. It's hard to pull out of engagements, which is probably a design decision. It's not necessarily a bad one. But they are going to continue just grinding them down in the rear, getting some good charges off, and then another charge going to come in into the back of these Principes.
Yeah, you just
try to overlap.
You just ripped through Jackie Fish's front line there. Now you're coming over to a hammer and anvil, my Principes, or fighting your Sacred Band. Not that the Sacred Band really needed help, but it's a good way to get them off the battlefield. And yeah, just playing this mod, it feels like this is important in any Total War game, but it's especially important to not get flanked and, you know, having to get hammered and anvil, which can just slaughter your morale and your army.
Yeah, especially in this mod, it's like it's literally all about those flanking penalties. That is the easiest, most effective way to get rid of stuff. So just beating, you're not gonna grind stuff down from the front. It'll literally take you like 30 minutes to win a hoplite battle between two hoplite units.
Yeah.
It's literally all about that cavalry. So you don't need necessarily amazing shot cav to cause those penalties, but you do need something in the rear line. And you can see how big those morale penalties are. Again, it's Dottie wavering at 180 men. They've only lost 50 or 60. Once you just get to about two-thirds health, they really start disliking what's going on.
Hannibal. He's breaking. He's wavering.
Hannibal is wavering. I doubt I'll be able to find him in this melee blob. But
yeah,
we'll
he's somewhere
him.
In there. First one to find Hannibal wins.
He's probably already dead. I didn't get the message.
I didn't get the notification either. I think he's still alive.
Aquitaine and is that Scipio? No, these are the Aquitaine. Yeah, Africana. Scipio's in there.
Scipio's
as well.
In there.
Yeah. So that's a really grindy melee fight. He did stabilize. Actually, 64 men left in the unit. I'm just not going to be able to win this, and I can't pull out of the engagement, or I will rout instantly.
Yeah,
so
I hate that.
He'll be grinding in there for a long time. I mean, it makes sense though, pulling away from other cavalry units. Like that's a tough proposition.
Oh, I found him.
Like you. Oh, where is he?
He's
that's gonna be cool.
Yeah, look for the guy.
Where is he in the unit, dude? Tell me.
He's all bloodied up though.
Oh my god, dude. You guys have gotten a disgusting surround off on my sacred band in the center. This is looking like flip flopped right now. Completely surrounded and cut off from the rest of my forces. You have the Hastati and two units of Hastati and a Principe in the back, just completely surrounding this blob with Sacred Band. But look at the damage they brought. I mean, these guys only have 94 kills. I think a lot of my Sacred Band have a lot more than that, though. Some of them are over 200 at this point. And they're still not wavering. They're still taking it out like a boss. They're still elite units. The elite units will take a long time to take off the field, for sure.
Yeah, I mean, it's got to be a pretty tough situation to be a Carthaginian right now. Seeing your general surrounded, being a Sacred Band and being surrounded, fighting back-to-back with some mercenary Celtic war band. It's pretty tough.
So over in the back lines here, we've got some more Hastati engaging my Sacred Band, who are again surrounded. It doesn't really matter where you look on the map. My Sacred Band are getting outnumbered and slaughtered. Balanced before very much Jackie Fish's and Apollo's favor. But Sacred Band have, these ones were in the back lines the entire time and just started to engage up to 31 kills, and they honestly will be able to do a ton of damage over here. And I do have free cav units. I have Sardinian archers who are now out of ammunition. I'm meat shielding against this cav unit because they were out of ammo as well. And now I have this mercenary Celtic cav that should be able to follow this blue line here, get around the flank. Actually, I'm gonna go for a rear charge on this Hastati first.
Oh.
That's gonna cause so much damage.
Oh man.
If I keep them in melee for just a little bit longer, look at that wavering instantly. Soon that unit will break. They're gonna break and run right through my Sacred Band, who will slaughter them without mercy. That is a engagement that might turn things back in my favor. We'll see.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty amazing, the Sacred Band, how long they're holding. I was expecting your army to just break as soon as your general was defeated, which, by the way, he did, you know, he retreated. I don't know if he died, but he retreated. But yeah, it's amazing how long your army is holding. I do really like that about this mod. And, we've got you outflanked on multiple spots, but that Sacred Band, man, they hold.
They are tanking it like a boss. As we get a nice overview of the battle, let's go into the overhead view and just kind of zoom in and see what's going on here. So you can see, completely surrounded, the mercenary Celtic war band and the Sacred Band archers. I have to engage them now because they're out of ammunition and I need them in melee to keep them alive. And then I have this one mercenary Celtic cavalry that is free. Oh, this frame rate, god, it's so glorious.
I know.
312 kills on the Celtic cav, and honestly right here I should have gone straight for Apollo's gen. I should have gone for Scipio and tried to take him off the field. I had a perfect rear charge. I instead decide to go around and go for the infantry, and I'm gonna kind of get caught up here and in between thinking about going for the infantry or the cav. I'm gonna pull him back, and then I see that Pixelated Apollo is actually gonna pull his cav out of there as well and not gonna go for the rear charge on them. So I kind of hesitated a bit too much here, which was definitely a mistake. I should have just gone straight for the infantry or gone straight for the gen and picked one. Instead I kind of waffle a bit there. But look at these Sacred Band, up to 208 kills now. Last time we checked they were at 90 or something. And they've almost broken this circle, this complete surround. They've almost completely broken it.
Yeah. Holy crap. Yep. Look how bloodied up they are. They're like, come on! Like, keep them coming! That is crazy.
Yeah, that Hoplon shield and those long spears and that sick, nasty Carthaginian training is keeping them in the fight for so much longer than you'd expect a normal Hoplite to be able to last. And now another rear charge off into this isolated unit. I have to keep picking off the isolated units. I can't really go for the big blobs yet, because I need to make sure that I need to free up as much infantry as possible to engage everything that's left in the center.
Yeah, because obviously we outnumber you, and if your cap dies, then I would say it's game over for you. Yeah. So it's pretty.
Cap is literally the only thing I can use to win this battle.
And that's what, you know, you were talking about being indecisive, but it makes sense because you don't want to just throw away your cap. You got to make sure you make good decisions or it's for sure game over. So overall, I think you. Oh, I formed square here. You see that?
Yeah.
It was pretty silly.
You can do it in formation, yeah.
Yeah, it's silly. Like, I shouldn't be able to form square once I'm engaged. I don't know. I always thought it would be cool. Like, there should be a proper way to, disengage from like, a melee fight. You know, like, slowly back away without losing too many soldiers.
Yeah, there was a Reddit post about that recently. People were
asking, really?
If you should be able to, retreat your guys backwards in formation, but like only extremely disciplined troops could do it. I think that'd be a really cool feature. Kind of do like a retreating center, like in Kanae, like have your main line in the middle and then pull them back, force the enemy infantry to move forward and then get enveloped easier by the cav on the flanks, which would be pretty awesome. But I don't know if that will ever get implemented in Total War. People have been talking about that for years and it's never gotten added. So I don't know if it's like a engine problem or if CA just doesn't think it's particularly realistic, because that kind of battle formation would be hard to pull off. Like, you have to be really disciplined to keep in order as your entire army, backs up.
That's why it makes sense to just do it with the disciplined troops. You know, if you have, peasant warband, you know, obviously they're not going to retreat, you know, in an organized way. But it would be great to see more stuff like that. You know, I would want to see less of the special abilities and more just formations and different tactics, but there goes your cav. They did everything they could in this battle. They're gonna go home and celebrate. I don't know. They did well.
I don't think they'll be celebrating after this one. Their entire army is going to be completely murdered. But
well, they're mercenaries, so they're like, we did enough.
That's a good point.
But they're not gonna get paid. So.
Well, and I mean, if you get 350 kills in a battle, you can definitely put that on your resume. Just say I was part of a really boss unit in the Carthaginian Punic Wars, so yeah. You should definitely hire us because we kill a lot of people.
Yeah, there you go. I mean, how do you say no to that?
You don't. You can't. It's impossible.
Yeah, most of the fighting is in this big blob over here. I'm just kind of surrounding with extra troops. Doesn't look like, since your cav has been killed, it doesn't look like you're going to be able to save victory here today. But you never know, these Sacred Band, man. If you guys are going to play as Carthage, you got to get these guys because they're so good.
They are. They're the best mainline infantry unit I've used in the mod. I've played three battles. I've used the Seleucids, and I've used a German faction. I can't remember what the name of their tribe was. Maybe the Frisii or Frizzy. I don't know how to say that. That might be wrong. But anyway, I've used both those factions, and both have some decent mainline infantry, but I have not seen any unit able to tank out engagements of the Sacred Band. And they don't even cost that much. Infantry in this mod is very cheap. Cavalry and the special units like Shot Cav and Elephants, those are where you really spend a lot of the big bucks. So like a mainline good infantry unit in this mod is like 500 or 600, but Cataphracts are like 1300 or 1400 a field.
Jeez, yeah. Well, maybe that's what they wanted to go with, you know, making it like, hey, Cav's really important. Like, we want to have a lot of infantry. You know, like in this battle, it was cool because, like you said earlier, like the infantry fights are so long. It's not so much about winning the infantry fights, but just holding the flanks and then getting your cav around to win the battle. So maybe that's why they, you know, made the cav so expensive. Is just if you lose them,
if you lose them, it's GG basically. Yeah. You need to have that mobility in this mod for sure. It's super important. I mean, you can see even the general units, like Scipio Africanus, 265 kills. Yes, the unit sizes are bigger, so the kill counts are going to be inflated, but that's still a lot of damage and a lot of hammer and anvils. And it's not even about the kills, really. It's about the units you can rout, because when units rout in this mod, they usually shatter. So that means they don't come back. That's a big change in the battle. And I am going to get ground down here. I have 600 Sacred Band left. You can see three separate engagements going on. Sacred Band over here could actually maybe even win that if this battle went long enough. But army losses are going to kick in pretty soon. These guys have absolutely no chance. And over here, they could maybe win. This is against Prink Paze and Tri-Aria. Yeah, probably not.
I form a Testudo formation a couple times. So if you look out for it, it's really cool. It sounds really cool. It looks really cool. So I do appreciate that. Small details.
Is it only when they move that it makes the Tetsudo sound?
As soon as you click the formation to do them, they're like, whoo, and you hear the shields like clash.
I don't think I'll be able to hear that in the replays.
Yeah. You gotta like be directly looking at them. I think I do it up there. You see where I just won on top? I think I do it with those two units once they form up. So just look out for that. It's pretty cool.
It's pretty cool.
It's pretty cool.
So yeah, it looks like Rome's gonna win the pubic wars here, which is unfortunate. We tried our best to hold the line and win the day, but
the numbers were just too much. Now it's just a slaughter.
Julius is way too good a general for us.
Oh yeah, way too good.
He's way too good. Like Hannibal Barca, he's an all right historical general, but Jubius Cornholius Scipio Africanus, that's next level right there.
You know what's really sad about these two generals? Both famous generals, but they didn't really ended up having like this. Like they both became just like politicians, I think, later on, kind of like losing their fame.
Why is that sad? I'd much rather be a politician than a dude who gets like slaughtered on the battlefield.
You're a general. You're not gonna get slaughtered. Your troops get slaughtered.
Well, the way we use our generals in this game, they were gonna get slaughtered.
That's true.
They were frontline troops in this one. Hannibal was literally like the first cav unit to get into melee combat. He was like, I want to kill some Romans today, boys.
I know. You're like, oh, I need to send support in that flank. But to be fair, Hannibal did fight in the front lines.
It didn't work.
Yeah,
in real life?
In real life, yeah. He got injured a lot. I mean, nearly dying a couple times.
I mean, I would definitely rather be the guy who sits in the back line and just says, you know what, guys? Feel free to go and die for your country. I would rather live here. And this poor Gallic guy in the back is just getting teamed up on by a bunch of Astati. You get knocked. Oh, is he dead? Oh, he's dead. Rest in peace, Mumford. Now, check this out. This is going to be insane. I don't remember which cav unit. I think it might have been the one that was hammer and ambling all the Principes and Astati you kept throwing into my back lines.
I'm pretty sure.
But, yeah, this one, I have never seen kills like that on infantry. I've seen one or two units get this amount of kills on, like, skirmishers and routing troops, but 766 kills for my mercenary Celtic horse.
Yeah, that's,
that is insanity.
Yeah, I mean, if you brought more cav, let's say you brought four units, and then maybe you even got less infantry and got more Sacred Band, you probably could form square and just try to hammer and anvil us, you know, as we try to take out your square. I mean, it is amazing how long those Sacred Band were holding. But that just shows go ahead.
I was just going to say, considering like how close that battle ended up being, even though it was 1v2, and yeah, you left funds on the table, but like I think my cavalry was like a big factor in being able to equalize.
Oh yeah. If you didn't use your cav like you did, the battle would have been a lot quicker. You know, it would have been over fast. I mean, that just shows how many troops we had, like how heavily outnumbered. You killed 800 men with one cav unit, and it's ridiculous. Now I
didn't win.
Well, I did throw in like a bunch of plebs, and I think he did get a cav charge with them.
Oh, you know what? You're right. That was also the same cav unit that got a bunch of kills on plebs at the beginning. You're right. So that was still half kills on Principes and Astati though.
Like, I'd probably be more
100 kills. Yeah, like that's a lot of kills regardless. Yeah. I mean, they definitely did work. Elephants, 500 kills. Some of them were on plebs for sure. So that number is inflated, and of course the bigger unit sizes. Archers, I can't. It says AOR. Okay, this is a good question for mod creators or anybody who knows. For a lot of these units, it says you can't see it because of the skull, but some of the units say AOR, and I don't know what that means. Like a lot of the units in this mod say that, and I don't know what that means on the unit card. So if somebody has an explanation for what AOR means, maybe it's an Omega. I think it's just AOR though. Please let me know. That would be nice. I mean, you can see my Mercenary Kilt Warband did all right. Sacred Band 307, 208, 260. Pretty solid, and they tanked it out for a long time. Hannibal Barker's unit 103 kills against Cav units, a lot of them. That's pretty solid. And then you can go over your
Well, it was pretty. I mean, nobody really shined bright here. I mean, it was just because I had so many troops. But I did get a couple hundred kills with the Principes. Some of them, you know, I got 100 kills. I think one of my Hastati got 164 kills, but I think that was killing archers. I can't really see the Triarii kills. I think I see 140, 100, 76, 98. So pretty solid from the Triarii, which, you know, they're veterans. But yeah, hopefully this gives you a good view of this mod. It's a little showcase battle. We weren't really taking this too seriously. I mean, Indie Pride, I don't think you could have won that battle if you tried, man.
I tried pretty hard, made it pretty close. But,
well, yeah, because, not saying that, like, you're not good enough to win it, but it's like we have.
No, you were definitely.
Okay, I was throwing some.
Very
triggered,
that's
true.
I'm very offended, and I don't think we can.
But yeah, I want to do a lot of historical battles with this mod. I think that would be a lot of fun, just recreating them, like what if.
Yeah,
like,
you can get this massive scale that you can get with other mods for sure. And the few battles that I played on it definitely do look very epic, cinematic in scope. And of course, what other mod can you play where Publius Cornelius Scipio Africanus can get 269 kills?
Yeah, that's true. That is true. All right, guys. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. And be sure to check out Indie Pride's channel. If you guys are watching My Point of View, he's got a great channel. Does a lot of Warhammer, something that I lack in. So if you're missing that, check him out. And we'll see him next time. See, we'll see you next time.
We will see you next time. See you guys. Have a good one.